The 2014 Quaker football season took flight over the weekend. I'm your host, Alexandra James. Welcome to the latest edition of This Week in Penn Athletics, your source for the quickest review of all things red and blue. Alec Torkerson with the first touchdown of the season in the opener against Jacksonville. Penn led for almost the entire game, up 31-19 halfway through the fourth quarter, but the Dolphins with a comeback, scoring 15 points to take the win. Sprint football also with their season opener, Penn down 13-0 in the fourth quarter until Captain Mike Beamish comes in to save the day, scoring two touchdowns, leading to a Quaker win by one. Men's soccer up against number 12 American on Thursday, an even playing field until a goal in the 88th minute leads to a loss for the Quakers. But on Saturday, with three goals in just under 5.5 minutes, Penn shuts out Temple. A scoreless game for women's soccer against VCU on Friday, but on Sunday, back from an injury, senior Caitlin Moore scores one for the Quakers, the team defeating Delaware. For volleyball, junior captain Alexis Gensi contributes 10 kills in a win against LaSalle in the Big Five tournament. The Quakers went 1-2 for the weekend. A tough Ivy opener for field hockey against Cornell ends in a 1-0 loss. The team will be back in action on Wednesday at Lafayette. And now for our hashtag Fight on Penn posts of the week. What's the loudest arena for a sporting event? ESPN's Joe Lunardi only needed one word to answer that question: Palestra. And Eric Bunn let us know this fun fact. Did you know Penn football has played the most games at any college level? Last week, you thought volleyball's trip to California trumped men's soccer in Washington. This week, we want to know your favorite Quaker performance. Retweet for Max Bogenhorn, who shut out Temple with 12 saves, and a favorite for Spencer Kolsar with 159 all-purpose yards against Jacksonville. For those results, you'll have to tune in next week. Until then, fight on, Penn.